Imagine growing up with a brother playing footy in the backyard, handballing, kicking goals, having a lot of contests, and then you bring it to the AFL stage. These two boys, Zach and Jackson Merritt, welcome to the Future Stars. How exciting is it playing together as two brothers in the same AFL side?
Yeah, I guess I was obviously there for a couple of seasons before Zach joined me at Essendon, but leading up to the draft, I suppose, I was in the recruiters' room every week asking what they thought of Zach and stuff, so it was very exciting when his name got read out and come to Essendon.
Jackson, we'll show a couple of highlights of you playing at the Bombers now. We're not going to talk about all the controversy that's been over the last couple of years, just purely the football. I mean, Joe Watson says he's not enjoying football, but I imagine at your age, just getting out there, getting your hands on the share and playing against some really good quality oppositions and a great part of your life.
Yeah, for sure. I suppose everyone says the first 50 games is a bit of a learning experience. So, yeah, I'm just wrapped to get it there and play as many games as I can. And I suppose we've got a few younger players playing at the minute, so it's just good energy around the club as well.
And when you first arrived on the scene, how difficult was it to just sort of adjust yourself to AFL life in general?
Yeah, for sure. I suppose I come from the country and like Cobden's a pretty small town, 1500 people, so it took a fair while for me to adjust, and missing home and stuff as well, so yeah, it took a while.
Now Zach, I think you did play together at Cobden, just it might have been in the under-14s for maybe one game, so tell us a little bit about playing with the older brother that's a couple of years older.
Yeah, I think I was 7 or 8 running around at training, just sort of following my brother around, and was lucky enough to get a call up one day because I was short, and I think I played for only 5 or 10 minutes, but yeah, that was all we got to do when we were younger.
There's been some great stories over the years about brothers. I think the most famous brothers are the Cracker brothers. Do you have that innate ability? There was a couple of times the other night where you found each other really well, and it looked like that brother cohesion was working really nicely.
Oh, yeah, it's a good question. I think we used to kick to one another a lot in the backyard, and we'd always swap and change from forward to mid. And I remember vaguely pretending to be the Sydney Swans and Ryan O'Keefe and Eamon Buchanan and kicking to one another in the backyard, so maybe a little bit.
Now, Jackson, I want to ask you this one. I had a brother that was 3.5 years older than me, and in the backyard, whether it was whatever sport it was, he gave me nothing, absolutely nothing. I had to earn everything I got. How did you go against each other, and what was the most competitive sport that you actually played?
Yeah, we had a few Barneys, I suppose, along the way. Cricket probably caused more grief. I remember Mum coming out nearly every time, like, oh, just calm down, boys, it's all right, it's only a game. But yeah, I think Zach wrapped the cricket bat around my head one time. That was probably the worst I got. So cricket was the brunt of it, yeah.
Very lucky to have a couple of brothers in here from the Bombers in Zach and Jackson Merritt. And Zach, let's talk about your year so far. You've played every game so far. You've averaged 22 disposals. Have a look at some of your highlights now, but you've really set yourself as a player on the up and an elite midfielder in the coming years.
Yeah, over the pre-season, I had a bit of to talk to Hurdy and Nathan Bass as my line coach, and talked about the second year Blues and saw that persona around the second year Blues. So I really try to have a consistent year, and so far it's been that.
And you boys, we discussed quickly before we went to the break about a couple of little biffs and scuffs you've had. But at the Melbourne Cup about 5 years ago, you both went toe-to-toe. How'd that go?
I think I might have pushed him through a window or something. And Dad wasn't so happy with that and chased me out the door. So, yeah, it was a very memorable Melbourne Cup.
Now, Jackson, I want to pick up on your pathway because yours is a wee bit different to Zach's in that you played for the Geelong Falcons. You stuck with them. It's in the era with Taylor Adams. We'll see some vision of you playing here. Devon Smith, what do you recall about your Falcons days?
Yeah, I suppose it was tough. I was an hour and a half away from Geelong, so travelling down there for training and stuff made it quite difficult. But there was a bus that left every Thursday night, and there was maybe 10 or 12 of us on that, so that made it a little bit easier. But yeah, there were some good players whilst I was there. Taylor Adams, obviously, Devon Smith. There was a few others, Jay Lever and Andrew Bosley. So there was a few that got drafted. And I think Jeb Buse is still at Geelong as well.
Now, a couple of years later, Zach, you're not at the Falcons. You've given them away. You've actually come up to Melbourne, to Melbourne Grammar, and you're going to play for the Sandringham Drag. What was the difference? What was the reason for that in the finish?
Yeah, it was an interesting process talking to Leon Harris and the Dragons down there with Ryan O'Connor. And yeah, it was just easy with travelling arrangements, being at Melbourne Grammar. It was only 25 minutes away instead of travelling to Geelong Tuesday and Thursday. So yeah, I was very fortunate, and Ryan looked after me really well. And yeah, I was again fortunate to play with some really good players with Josh Kelly, Christian Salem and Nathan Freeman.
And like a lot of people, Mum and Dad play a major role in your footy and your footy development. Your dad, Jackson Gregg, he umpired football. There's a little bit of a rumour that he might have cost you a few votes along the way, but what was it like having a dad that was involved in your footy while you were going through?
Yeah, it was good. Obviously, Dad would do anything for me and Zach. Our mother can't drive, so he obviously drove us everywhere, but he used to umpire me as a junior, and I think he even coached Zach when he was in juniors. So.
And also, just with yourself, Zach, mum's role, she's your greatest fan of you two boys?
Yeah, she's definitely number one fan, and I think gives us the most advice and also cheers us on the most. So, yeah, it's very good to see her smile when she watches us play.
In my first year, my mum turned up to an aftermatch with a Bulldogs jumper on a number 17. She hasn't done anything stupid like that, has she?
Not quite. I think not she yet. Sticks to the staff and the Badgers.
Mum's name, Kathy?
Kathy, yeah.
Good stuff.
Now, Zach, you're obviously a gun cricketer, played under 13s and 15 state cricket. I've got a question for you. What would you rather be doing, playing on the MCG or Lords this weekend?
Yeah, well, after St Kilda's loss a couple of weeks ago, I think Lords looks pretty good, but I wouldn't say no to a grand final day in the AFL.
Now, the Merritt name is synonymous with Essendon. Roger Merritt, a great champion player back in the 80s, predominantly. But there's another Merritt that's a household name in the Collingwood world, and that's, of course, Thurl Merritt, your great uncle. Any advice from Thurl over the years? And I know that I was brought up in Thurl in the 70s and the 80s on the world of sport, watching the Sunday footy show back then.
Yeah, he certainly encouraged me to use the left foot like he had. He had that spearing left foot, so I sort of try to take after him.
And Thurl Merritt was a name that I come run by at one stage. Brownie, he coached against me in an under-17s grand final. We just lost by a short margin of 24 goals. Best on the ground was Robert DiPietro-Domenico, kicking 11 goals for Thurl Merritt's Boleyn Templestowe.
Very nice, Plough. Talks about Matthew Lloyd's role down there as a goal-kicking coach. He blokes play in the forward line midfield. How much contact do you have with him? And he's doing a pretty good job with Joe Hannah-Danaher.
Yeah, he's obviously his main role is with Joey and Jake Carl on the beer guys and the goal kicking, but yeah, it's good just to be able to pick his brain a goal like that with so much experience.
Boys, thanks very much for joining us. So I think the Bombers fans are going to get great joy out of watching you two over the next 10 to 12 years. Good luck for the rest of the season and into your careers.
Thanks, boys.
Thanks for having us.